This video is about wiring and setting up a Batrium battery management system on a GoodWe high voltage hybrid inverter. High voltage batteries operate up to 1000 volts and present a significant risk to non-experts. All of the steps shown here are intended for people who really know what they are doing. The author of this video assumes no responsibility for property damage or personal injury. More and more inverters are designed for high voltage batteries because they are significantly more efficient, allow smaller cable diameters, and allow better protection. For most inverters, there is often only one or few batteries approved by the manufacturer. However, homemade batteries for high voltage inverters are generally neither intended nor permitted. Therefore, the use of non-approved batteries may void any warranty. The communication between the inverter and the energy storage system, also known as the battery, usually takes place via CAN bus or Modbus. Its purpose is to exchange voltage and current values for charging and discharging, or health information like SOC, SOH, or warnings and alarms. With invalid or no data, the inverter disconnects the battery. Now we first want to take a closer look at GoodWe's high voltage inverters. The models from the ET, EH, BT and BH series are suitable for our application. The main difference between these models is the number of phases to the grid and the ability to connect PV modules via MPPT inputs. Matching these inverters, GoodWe offers two high voltage batteries called Lynx S and Lynx F, which are highly recommended for all regular users, and whose communication protocol is also interesting for our application. The Batrium BMS has a modular structure and consisting of a central component, the Watchmon core, and decentralized balancer modules. High voltage systems require isolated balancers for a large number of battery cells. Batrium recommends the cell-made K9 module for this application. Up to 20 cell-made K9 modules for 16 cells each can be connected in series. The Watchmon core module has a terminal labeled CAN bus at the top right, which can be used to connect to an inverter. Now let's take a closer look at the connection of a high voltage battery. Here you can see a GoodWe GW10K ET inverter, which in addition to the two MPPT string inputs for the solar panels, has a third DC connection for the high voltage battery. Further to the right, there's an RJ45 socket inside the inverter enclosure for connecting the supplied communication cable labeled to battery. A look at the installation instructions shows the assignment of the RJ45 connector for the BMS connection. Pins 4 and 5 in the middle of the connector are of interest to us. So a regular keystone socket is sufficient, where we only connect the blue and the blue-white wires in the middle. On the other side of the cable is our Batrium Watchmon core, connecting the blue wire to the first position, label H, and the blue and white wire to the second position, labeled L of the CAN bus terminal. With longer cables, it is recommended to connect the shielding in the third position, which is marked G. Now we can start configuring the BMS using the Watchmon Toolkit software. First, you navigate via the menu button to Hardware and then to Integration. A click on the Edit button enables the setting of the CAN bus functions. First, the broadcast function must be switched on, and then the Reserve 29 option must be selected under protocol mode. Newer firmware versions could already offer the correct inverter type from GoodWe for selection. The remote address field is also important here, which is used to tell the inverter how many battery modules each with approximately 52 volts, are connected in series. In our example, there are 8 modules with 16 cells each, so we put an 8 in here. Now we navigate via the menu to control logic and remote. By clicking on Edit, you set the template to ramped targets and select the plausible charging curve for the battery based on the specification of the cells used. In our example, we reduce the charging current from a SOC of 99.5% to 12 amps and from 100% to 5 amps. And at over 100% or when limited charging power is requested, to 2 amps. The maximum discharge current must also correspond to the specification of the battery cells used. After clicking on Save, we are ready to continue the setup on the inverter. The inverter is set up using GoodWe's PV Master app. First you select the inverter and then you navigate to Settings and select the first item, Basic Settings. Now select the valid grid parameters for your country and the operating mode. The appropriate battery type must now be selected. To do this, select the manufacturer GoodWe and then select the model LXFH. After a short wait, this message should appear. Now press OK and complete the setup with Next and Exit. Now we have a look at the inverter. If everything worked, the blue battery LED on the left side should be visible, and the green battery symbol on the right side should show the SOC. In the PV Master app, battery type, state of charge, voltage and current should be visible, and after a short while, also in the SEMS portal. In Batrium's Watchmon Toolkit software, the measured values of the inverter should now be visible under Control Logic Remote on the right side in the column labeled Actual. The other column, labeled Target, shows the data that is sent to the inverter. At the bottom of Canvas Monitoring, the ticks on TX and RX should count up evenly. If you made it this far and the Batrium BMS is talking to your inverter, please take the time to thoroughly check and adjust the balancer parameters under Hardware Salmon and the parameters under Control Logic. Also, in most cases, an inverter will disconnect from the battery as soon as the BMS communication indicates a fault. It is recommended to use a 500 volt rated DC shunt trip or contactor to cut the battery off safely. Please also pay attention to the proper insulation of all live parts of the high voltage battery. Last but not least, I wish you every success in building and operating your own high voltage battery. If you have any questions or comments about this, please post them below. If you like this video and want to see more of it, please like and subscribe to my channel.